So yeah, you haven't slept in 3.5 days, and things are getting incredibly weird for you lately. You're pretty sure you just noticed something in the corner of your eye. You're in your living room.
Well, I turn my head to look.
You see nothing.
Is the TV on?
The TV isn't on. It's all quiet.
Okay, I stand up from my chair and I walk into the kitchen to make myself a peanut butter sandwich, and I open the fridge.
In the fridge, you find a peanut butter sandwich, ready-made.
That's pretty strange. I take it out and I take a bite.
It's delicious.
Sweet. I take it with me as I walk back into my living room. And I sit down on the sofa again, and I turn on the TV.
Okay, you turn on the TV. And you see your kitchen.
On the TV screen?
Yep. On the screen, you've just seen yourself open the fridge, take out a peanut butter sandwich and eat it.
Wow, that's really strange. I start and I run out to the kitchen, leaving my peanut butter sandwich behind. From the angle where the TV showed me. I look for a camera.
You can't see any camera.
I wave my hand and then run back into the living room to look at the TV.
Okay. You look on the TV and you see yourself run into your kitchen looking around to try to see something. A few moments later, you see yourself wave a hand.
Change the channel of the TV. I rub my eyes and change the channel.
Okay. You see your kitchen.
I change the channel again.
You see yourself taking a sandwich out of your fridge.
I turn off the TV and walk back into my kitchen.
Okay. As you get up and you start walking to the kitchen, you see yourself walk into the kitchen.
On the TV?
No.
I tried to grab myself.
You tried to what?
I tried to grab myself, the myself that I see.
Okay, the moment you try to grab yourself, you sort of just disappear.
I rub my eyes and walk into the kitchen.
Okay, clearly the fridge is open.
Clearly my tiredness is getting to me. I look into the fridge.
There's a perfectly formed, nice looking peanut butter sandwich.
I grab the peanut butter sandwich and take a bite.
It's delicious.
I walk into the living room and sit down and turn on my TV.
You see your kitchen.
I run into my kitchen. No, okay, no. I start as I realize that I'm in some strange time loop. I look at the potted plant in the corner to try to take my mind off what just happened.
Okay, you stare at the potted plant to try to take your mind off everything.
I look back towards the TV.
You see your kitchen.
Is anything happening on the TV?
A few moments later, you notice yourself walk into the kitchen, open the fridge, and take out a potted plant.
I get up and walk into the kitchen.
You walk into your kitchen.
I look at the fridge.
The fridge is closed.
I shrug and open the freezer, looking for something to put in the oven. I'm quite hungry.
You find a perfectly made peanut butter sandwich.
Is it frozen?
Nope.
I take out the end of the sandwich and have a bite.
As you take the sandwich, you notice that it's pretty hard to grip it when your arm is a leaf.
I stare at my hand.
Looks like a nut leaf, very similar to the potted plant you had.
I shrug, try to close the freezer with my greenery, and I walk back into the living room and sit down.
You manage to close the freezer and go sit down.
I look at the TV.
The TV shows your kitchen.
Is there anything happening on the TV?
Just your kitchen.
I change the channel on the TV.
You have to use your left arm because your right arm is currently a leaf.
Okay, I grab the remote with my left arm and change the channel.
You see your kitchen.
I change the channel again, trying to get away from this boring cooking show that doesn't seem to have any persons in it.
After flipping the channel a few times, you manage to see something that isn't your kitchen. It's as if the camera is pointing to the potting plant in the living room.
I stare at the TV screen.
It's displaying a potted plant.
I stand up, walk over to the TV and turn it off.
You turn up your television.
I turn around and look at the potted plant.
You see yourself.
I lift up my arm and wave.
You wave. At yourself.
Does my other self also wave or not?
No, it doesn't. It doesn't wave.
I look at my other self's arm. Is it a pot plant? Or is it a leaf rather?
You look perfectly fine. Healthy even.
I look at my own hand. Is it still a leaf?
It's still a leaf.
I walk over and try to slap myself with my leaf arm.
You giggle, tickled by the leaf.
With my left arm, I begin to strip off my other self's shirt.
Your other self in front of you looks a bit confused as to what you're doing, but doesn't try to stop you. You now have your other self's t-shirt.
I put it on over my old t-shirt.
You're now wearing two t-shirts.
Is it the same t-shirt?
Yes.
I shrug, turn around and walk upstairs.
You enter your kitchen.
I open the fridge.
There's a perfect form of peanut butter sandwich in there.
I take a bite out of the peanut butter sandwich.
It's delicious.
I put the peanut butter sandwich back in the fridge, close the door, walk through my living room upstairs.
You enter your kitchen.
I look at the cactus in my window.
You see a cactus.
I try to grab the cactus with my plant arm.
It doesn't hurt, but the cactus is very prickly.
Have I managed to lift it up?
You don't manage to lift it, or leaf arm isn't strong enough.
I shrug, walking to my living room and sit down to watch some television.
You see your bedroom?
On the television?
Yes.
I wonder why my bedroom is on the TV and I try to switch the channel.
You see your kitchen?
I try to switch the channel again.
You see your kitchen?
I shrug and walk upstairs.
You enter your kitchen.
I open the freezer.
You see a perfectly formed peanut butter sandwich.
I take a bite.
It's delicious.
I take another bite. Actually, I swallow the whole thing. I eat the whole thing.
You almost choke trying to consume a whole sandwich in one bite. After a bit of coughing, you find yourself fine. It was delicious.
I close the freezer and open it back up again.
You see a perfectly formed peanut butter sandwich.
I take the peanut butter sandwich and stuff it in my underwear.
Well, that felt awkward.
I take it out and I put it in the fridge.
You put the somewhat mushy peanut butter sandwich from your underwear and place it next to the perfectly formed peanut butter sandwich in your fridge.
I look out the window of my kitchen.
You see your garden.
What season is it?
Autumn.
I punch the window with as much power as I can muster, trying to break it.
Ow, that hurt.
Did the window break?
No.
I headbutt the window.
Ow, that hurt.
I look down at my arm. Is it still a plant leaf?
Yes.
I walk into my living room, sit down to watch some TV.
You see your kitchen.
Is there anything happening on the TV screen?
It's just your chin.
I scratch my chin with my leaf arm and I stand up and I try to walk upstairs again.
You went to your bedroom.
Finally. I walk over to my bookshelf and grab a book as I lay down in my bed and start reading it.
It's a 300-page cookery book.
I try to find a recipe including carrots. I'm having an I'm feeling like cooking something with carrots.
It's a shame then that you can find the recipes for sandwiches.
I try to find a sandwich recipe that would include carrots.
You don't find one.
I browse through the book, looking at what other recipes I might find.
It seems to comprise entirely of recipes for peanut butter sandwiches.
I shrug, close the book, and lay down in bed, closing my eyes.
It's a shame you can't sleep.
I realize I'm too hungry to sleep. I walk out of bed and walk downstairs.
You enter your living room.
I turn off the lights, wondering why I didn't do it before going to bed, and I head into my kitchen.
You enter your kitchen.
I open the fridge.
You see a potted plant.
I stare at the potted plant.
It stares back.
I take it out of the fridge.
You are now holding a potted plant.
I put it down on the kitchen table and open the fridge again.
You see a potted plant.
I grab that one as well and put it next to the other one. Yo! That leaf. That potted plant on the stream, Jesus.
There are two potted plants on your kitchen side.
I look at them and compare them.
They're identical. They're identical to the one in the living room, before it was you.
I open the freezer.
You see a perfectly formed peanut butter sandwich.
I take it out and take a bite.
It's delicious.
I keep eating until I finish it. And I walk through my living room back upstairs.
You went to your bedroom.
I lay down in bed and close my eyes.
It's a shame you can't sleep.
Haunting images of potted plants keep me awake as I walk into my living room, through my living room into my kitchen, and I start filling a glass with water.
You have a glass of water.
I walk into my living room and stare at my potted plant.
You see a potty, see a potted plant.
I walk over to the potted plant and pour the glass of water into the soil.
You can't tell, but you're pretty sure the potted plant is thankful.
I look down at my arm. Is it still a leaf?
Yes.
With my leafy arm, I stroke the potted plant.
You caress it gently. If it could talk, it would tell you it was happy.
I walk back into my kitchen and look at my table.
You see two perfectly formed butter sandwiches.
I take out both of them and I open a drawer to look for some plastic wrap.
You find some plastic wrap.
I wrap the sandwiches and I open the freezer door.
You open the freezer door.
I put the sandwiches in the freezer and close the door.
You do.
Hmm?
You do what you just said, yep.
Okay. And with that, I walk out of the kitchen and I walk out of my home.
By the front door?
Yes.
It's a lovely day.
I walk down the street looking for someone to talk to.
That's funny. There doesn't seem to be anyone around.
I look at a nearby tree.
Hello, says the tree.
Hello, Mr. Tree. Could you explain what's going on?
I don't know what you mean, says the tree.
I show the tree my plant arm. I think I'm turning into one of you.
Oh, that's good news.
Is
it? I'm very happy for you, says the tree.
I'm not sure I want to be one of you.
That's sad, says the tree.
I walk up to the tree and rip off one of its leaves from its branches.
The tree screams in agony.
I laugh and pull off another handful of leaves.
It screams further. You're sure it's crying. It's doing nothing but warbling and telling you why. Why are you doing this, you fucked up bastard?
I punch the stem of the tree.
Ow, that hurt.
I kick the tree.
Ow, that hurt.
I gnaw at the tree's bark with my teeth, trying to rip off as much of the bark as I can.
You don't get much.
I curse at the tree and walk off.
The tree's far too busy screaming in agony to deal with you right now.
I look down at my feet.
You see your shoes.
Weird. When did I put on those? I keep walking down the street. I'm trying to get to the shop.
You get to the shop.
I walk into the shop.
You walk into the shop.
I pad my pockets to see if I brought my wallet.
Looks like you forgot that.
I look around the shop with a mischievous look. And I walk up to the candy aisle and sneakily I put a candy bar in my pocket.
You put a peanut butter sandwich in your pocket.
I nod at the cashier and leave the store.
You leave the store.
I walk back to the tree.
The tree is still screaming in pain.
I offer the peanut butter sandwich as a token of good faith.
The tree is inconsolable and in agony.
I humph and throw the peanut butter sandwich at the tree.
It hits the tree.
Here I am, giving a perfectly good peanut butter sandwich, and all you do is scream at me?
The tree doesn't respond in anything other than pain cries.
I take another gnaw at the tree's bark.
That was vindictive.
I walk back into my house. And into the kitchen.
You enter your kitchen.
I open the fridge.
You see a potted plant.
I start ripping off its leaves.
What a sad thing to do to a potted plant.
I pick up the potted plant and smash it against the floor.
It smashes into pieces.
I kick it.
You kick the smashed potted plant.
I look down at my arm. Is it still a potted plant leaf?
Your arm is your arm again.
I make a victory gesture and I walk upstairs.
You cannot get upstairs. There's a potted plant in the way.
I growl at the potted plant and warn it to get out of my way.
It doesn't seem to think much of your threats.
I spit at it.
You spit on the potted plant.
I warn it the final time to move out of the way, or something bad's gonna happen to it.
The potted plant doesn't seem too intimidated.
I sigh and sit down in my living room and turn on the TV.
You see a potted plant.
I change the channel, I'm tired of these plants.
You see two potted plants.
I guess it's that porno hour on TV, I switch the channel again.
You see four potted plants arranged around a tree that seems to be crying.
I turn off the TV.
You see a potted plant.
I attempt to turn off the TV yet again.
You see two potted plants.
I throw the remote at the TV.
You hit a potted plant.
I stand up and look at my body.
You look fine.
I walk upstairs.
There's still a potted plant in the way.
I pick the potted plant up and throw it at the TV.
You throw the potted plant at the other potted plant.
I walk up the stairs.
You enter your bedroom.
I look at my bed.
There's a potted plant.
I pick up the potted plant and throw it out the window.
The potted plant bounces off the window and lands, covering the floor with dirt.
I pick out the plant from the dirt and shrapnel and start ripping its leaves off one by one, singing as I do it.
What a horrible thing to do to a potted plant.
Love me not! Loves me, loves me not, loves me as I rip off its leaves.
What a horrible thing to do to a potted plant.
I lay down in bed and try to sleep.
It's a shame you can't sleep.
I cover myself with my blankets, trying to keep the potted plants away.
You bring up a potted plant across your chest.
Oh God! Oh Jesus! I shriek in terror, throw the potted plant across the room, and stand up, going over to my bookshelf, trying to find a book to read to take my mind off this.
You have several books to choose from.
I look for some fiction.
You have many fiction books.
I pick out a fantasy fiction book.
You pick up a peanut butter sandwich.
I open the peanut butter sandwich and start reading.
You don't understand Braille.
I wish I was deaf right now. I eat the peanut butter sandwich.
It's delicious.
I look to the bookshelf again and try to pick out another book.
The bookshelf is covered in sandwiches.
I try to read the backs of the sandwiches, finding where I put my fiction.
All you see is sandwiches.
In despair, I turn around, crouch to the floor, and look under my bed.
You see a potted plant.
Jesus! I pull the potted plant out from under my bed.
You're holding a potted plant.
I stare at it intently.
It doesn't seem to be particularly intimidated.
I start grabbing the soil out of the pot and strewing it across the floor.
What a horrible thing to do to a potted plant.
I keep going until the pot is empty of soil and there's only a root of the plant left.
You empty the pot of soil.
I walk over to the bookshelf and look at my collection of books yet again.
You look at your collection of sandwiches.
I start filling the potted plant with sandwiches.
You fill the potted plant with sandwiches.
I place the potted plant back underneath my bed and walk down into my living room.
You enter your living room.
I look at the TV.
You see a potted plant.
I shriek, and I try to turn off the TV.
You can't turn off the potted plant.
I look at my grandfather clock hanging on the wall.
You see a potted plant.
I look at my old school record player on the bookshelf.
You see a potted plant.
I walk over to the potted plant, try to bend one of the leaves down, as if I was trying to put on a record.
You can't get to the potted plant. There's a potted plant in the way.
I kick the potted plant aside and try to get to the record player.
You kick the potted plant, it falls onto another potted plant.
This is fucking nightmare fuel! I look at my body, making sure
You're
I'm not...
You're a horrible potted plant.
I wiggle my leaves around.
You wiggle your leaves.
I look over to the archway leading into the kitchen.
It's difficult to see through all the potted plants.
I make my way over to the kitchen.
You can't move. You're a potted plant.
I look towards the stairs leading to my bedroom.
It still has the potted plant on it.
I try to speak plantish to the other plants around me.
That's silly. Plants can't talk.
I remember the tree and try to imitate its voice.
Trees don't have voices.
I close my eyes.
You really fancy a sandwich.
I look into the I look at my feet.
Potted plants don't have eyes.
I listen.
Potted plants don't have ears.
I feel.
Potted plants can't feel.
I sit in quiet darkness for all eternity.
Because that's what potted plants do.
Indeed.
Game over.
Man, that was fucking great. I fucking love you.
Can I start laughing now?
Yes.
Fucking hell.
This shit's going fucking on YouTube, Jesus Christ. Wow, that was really good, man. Wow.
I'm actually shaking because I'm trying not to laugh and I feel so on the spot and it's like, I'm actually shaking.
Wow, I can't believe you did that. Like, improv, that's fucking great.
Well, one thing's for sure. I think you'll be moving the potted plant in your living room tomorrow.
I'm fucking moving them out of my room tonight, Jesus, how will I be able to sleep? Alright, man, thanks a lot, that was great.
No worries, bye.
Bye-bye.